Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at how you could use filters in Numbers. So I'm using Numbers version 3 here and I'm going to show you filtering. And filtering is a way to take a large table and only see some of the rows in it. So for instance, I have just a list of states and territories here and it's got population and coastline. And it might be an obvious thing that I want to filter by only states that have coastline. And it's easy to do that. I can select up here, select the header above each column here, and I can say filter table, and it's going to give me all the values that are contained there. And in this case, it's a checkbox, so it's only true and false. If I were to try to filter this one, you'd see it has all the different values, which there's a unique one for each one. So it doesn't make sense to filter by that. But filtering by true makes sense, and you can see now I only have the rows where this is checked off. And you can see that it even gives you the row numbers skipping the ones that it's not showing you. So the data is still there, you're just not seeing it, and it's just an easier way to be able to view the data in a table. I could very easily go filter table and change to false, and now it's going to basically turn that off, or it's going to basically give me both. So I can turn off true, and now I can see that I'm only seeing those. So you can see there is a way to filter and say if there are 10 different categories, I could filter it and have it show me 5 out of the 10 categories by checking off which ones I want. Now another thing I could do is I could use the filter button over here. You can see it next to format with the whole table selected, and I can add a filter for the entire thing. I can pick the column I want. So let's do population now. And I want it to be states with a population that are greater than, and let's say 5 million. And you can see it filters the table, taking out all of the rest of the states that are there. And I can see how many there are. Now you can combine filters. So I've still got this filter in place. If I select the table, I still have the population greater than 5 million. I can use this interface up here or this interface over here to add another filter. So let's show rows where coastline is true. And you can see it adds it here. And now I just have states with population of 5 million or over and coastline is true. I can even add an extra filter, like for instance population is less than 10 million. So I've actually filtered the same column twice, greater than 5 million and less than 10 million. It's easy to add, to remove these. You use the little trash can button over here that appears when you roll over, or you could have just used the checkbox there, temporarily turn them off. So it could be something you turn on and off as you need when you're working with the table. You have tons of criteria for filtering. So you know, you've got a set that goes with numbers. You have a set that goes with text. You can do it with dates, even durations between things, and whether or not cells are blank. So you can kind of filter those out as well. And it will filter out the entire row based on what it finds in just one cell in the row, in other words, one column going through.